remember the way to the witch's house?
Yes. The woods with the blood red leaves. South of the lake. I know just where to go. Hope she made it back from Alfheim and can bring Mimir back. He seemed nice. Before you cut off his head. Look at this place. This must be a branch of the world tree.
Boy, stay on the path.
Right, I know. I can't believe it was Baldur that came to our house. The Aesir god. Baldur. And you fought him. And won!
Yes.
One of Odin's sons. Thor's brother. And now he's hunting us with his nephews. Why is this happening?
If we can raise the head, you can ask him.
Okay. You know, it's silly, but I secretly hope we find a giant somewhere in that mountain. I guess they really did leave Midgard, except for the Serpent. He may be the last of his kind. Are you the last of your kind, too? Is that why you don't like to talk about
my kind?
I mean, your family. Before Mother and I. Where you came from. Mother, a father?
Now is not the time for that.
Yes, sir.
Wow. Rock! Rock! Rock!
What? I'm on a fucking break. Don't hear me screeching at you whenever you're twiddling your short and curlies.
Leave him, boy.
No, Pep. Well, you already soiled my solitude, so you may as well join me.
You're not hungry.
Good. It's not what I was offering.
Saw your brother again.
Congratulations. And I'm sure you'll let him go and Roger my axe good and plenty again, Let's see the damage. Canker throat wouldn't know proper weight and balance if it were dangling off his chut. He eating well enough?
I guess.
Good. All better. Now what the fuck else you want, huh? Times he gets so wrapped up in his work, Sentry hasn't the sense to sip or sup. And if he does remember, good luck getting him to cook his own meat. Guess I got all the stomach in the family. Along with the smarts.
You miss him.
What, that spit fister? What do you know?
I just mean
hey, do you mind? Trying to concentrate here, already on a break.
Boy, what is the path back to the witch?
First, we need to find a boat.
Do you remember the way back to the witch from here?
That way, behind the big statue of Thor. I wish we could have gone on a trip like this with Mother. She could fight, couldn't she?
Yes, she fought beautifully.
some statue. Who built it, you think?
I do not know.
Know any good stories to pass the time?
What kind of story?
I don't know. Mother always had stories. Weren't you told any when you were a boy?
There was a man I knew of long ago. His stories were brief and purposeful.
Sounds fun? Do you remember any?
There was one that concerned a hare and a tortoise.
Like the witch's house?
Unlikely.
So what happens?
They wager on a race between them. The hare is too confident of victory and foolish, while the tortoise is steady and disciplined. The tortoise wins.
You haven't told a lot of stories, have you? Hey, we can dodge here.
Water dropped.
And the serpent rose. Right. I know she's really powerful, but you really think the witch can bring a head back to life?
She seems competent in her craft. And we have nothing to lose.
If she can't bring it back to life, can we keep the head?
No. But you may feed it to the fish.
Okay. I bet this will lead out. Hey, this does more than decipher those Muspelheim runes. It also contains the travel rune. Should we go visit the fire realm? Smart. turned back to Aesir. Guess the gods aren't welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie. Death to the Raven God, Lord of the Hang.
Read it.
Sir. Say their needs upon all who trespass. She is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Pamela! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Oh. Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either. Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are God.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
Now!
You're welcome!
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your counsel, head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Better to tell us the way.
The World Serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
It's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
The boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
You never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
Thank you. Wish me luck. He remembers me. Why, you... Oh, no, that's not right. Mokuno Huntun-kun. Eko no tunno funora.
Knows the pain of your loss. He will help you.
Curious.
What is it?
Nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're heading in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one on the peak where we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
Get to the boat. We can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir... have proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. And we'll pick this up later.
Ah, Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads? Was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Greedy little dwarf come dragon.
You've never answered the boy's question, Head. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
I'm coming to it!
that one, brother.
I don't know, lad. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs.
Sir.
go, you wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Here, boy.
Ah, I was wondering about this.
Thank you.
The mirror. You were in the middle of a story before. What were you saying about the Long War?
Enough is enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. Took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people, a selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Ulvik. You were taken from this realm too early. You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Prepare yourself!
Without her spirit.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out,
look
while
if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly,
He caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamyr fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. But truth is, the sweaty clawbag just got lucky.
Fight them? A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Almost there!
Tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Trick, lad.
Thanks. It's his idea.
To
the survivors.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
We'll need something to get through this one.
Atreus, to me!
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Enemies. On your mark. An Alfheim light crystal. Wonder what it's for.
Over to the left!
I see something up there. Hey, hardened world tree sap. That's handy. Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw, but how do we get it down?
What does it say?
Yes, sir. To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Wow, that was, something, that, fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. What can I do for you two?
Oh, we can't forget you. What more do you need?
Amazing.
Try keeping that clean. Be seeing ya. Let's do it. If I say so myself. You don't have to run off on my account.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, Farmer really liked jewelry, didn't he? Even braided his beard with it.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
Right here!
Hey, Sindri. Could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't have much else going on right now.
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
Oh! my shot.
Mimir, you knew this place? Before?
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
Another crystal. Just give the word. Most of it.
Well, a stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do? Why are we going up when what we need is all the way down there?
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
Going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip.
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck.
You are welcome to suggest a different one.
now?
Hold tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Quiet.
Jump!
That didn't work. It only fell a little ways. Oh no! The floor's collapsed. There's a sand bowl, but how do we get to it?
We cannot. Boy. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song Mother used.
I know that one!
Winter that...
Quiet, Head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it!
Write it.
Vetter. House. Var. Sumar. No, that wasn't right.
Boy.
Vetter. Vaur. Sumar. House. It didn't work, but I know that's the order in the song Mom sang.
Do it.
Vetter. Var. Sumar. House. It didn't work, but I know that's the order in the song Mom sang.
Thank you.
Write it.
Yes.
Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform.
Keep writing.
Thola. Thola. Thola.
Ed, how is this possible?
My guess? Temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them, always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
I can't get to the wolves!
To writing before the floor collapses.
Thank you.
Jump! You did well.
Thanks.
The boy.
Just having a little fun, you big grump.
Well, there it is. How are we going to get it free?
A push. Trust me. Ready. Dig in and push with everything.
Yes, sir. How do we get down?
We jump.
Really?
Come. Do not panic!
Why would I panic?
Whoa. I have you!
You're cracked, you know that?
Well. Good. We should keep moving.
The chisel tip!
Give the man credit. He has a talent for destroying things.
Remember that head.
Never leaves my mind.
Those were the guys we saw with Baldur. His nephews?
Aye. Magni and Modi. Sons of Thor.
Mother always said the Aesir were the worst of gods, and Thor was the worst of the Aesir. Guess he's a terrible father, too.
They are no longer children. They have no excuse.
Will Sindri be okay?
We'll never even see him. Ah, the great dining hall. Envy of all Midgard. You just can't help but break things, can you? If memory serves, the Jarl's throne was just on the other side of that wall of ice.
We'll need something to get through this one.
Ready yourself, boy!
Thank you. he, lad? He's fine.
Thought it best to vanish when Thor's idiot sons showed up.
Hey, Sindri, we found something.
Armor piece? Oh, I hope it's a new armor piece.
Oh, the travelers.
Oh, disgusting. Smelly, covered in God knows how many little beasties, but gorgeous armor. Let's see if I can't make something more sanitary. Yes? So, what can I do for you two? Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers.
Hey, brother, we may get a piece of the chisel and be gone before they even notice.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Boy.
Surrender. The old father demands it.
No.
Good.
This fight is mine, boy. Go.
And where do you think you're going? Oh no, brother. The little freak's got a bow. What are we gonna do? Yeah!
Odin want.
Don't know. Don't get it. Come here, Hathaway. Your thunder on your daddy's hand.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
Yeah! Yeah! Can't believe you've lasted this long. Those skinny little arms can barely
I said shut up!
Calm yourself, boy.
Looks like they need another lesson.
Nothing to teach you.
Atreus!
the luck of him.
I'll kill you!
Atreus! Control yourself!
You have no idea. You son of a bitch!
No, no. Come back to Midgard! Oh, Atreus!
Sickness. Fever has returned.
No! It has it.
Boy!
The coffin, the blood. The boy's sick, he needs Freya.
No!
Steady.
I'll be all right.
There you go, lad.
I'm fine, see?
We should keep an eye on him.
Enough.
Should do. With that, we can carve the travel rune to Jotunheim. Get you where you need to go. Oh, incidentally, all those magically sealed doors we've seen can now be unlocked. Like that one round the corner. You can get through that door there now that you've got the chisel.
Boys, bring up!
You killed Magni.
That he did.
He was a god. But you killed him.
Minor Aesir, perhaps. But I.
And his father is Thor.
Not minor. Not minor at all, him. This will not go over well in Asgard.
I defended us. Nothing more. I fear no judgment.
Judgment, no. But if vengeance is any concern.
Since when can you kill a god?
Made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Wait, we were here before. But which way back?
I don't think the lad's doing too well.
I'm fine.
If so, then keep up.
Yes, sir.
Agni didn't come back to life.
That is interesting. It's known the Aesir find their own way to Valhalla. No Valkyrie escort, no processing at the gates of Helheim. That may be significant.
Giant's End. What? What is this place?
Fishermen would bring the day's catch into this port and use that contraption to send some of it directly to the Jarl's main kitchen. The rest were sorted and sold.
There is an exit under the thumb. Find a way across. There is an opening.
I can get it. There's a path to the exit, on the other side.
Back under his palm. We're almost there.
Everything we just did. Climbed around a dead giant, rode a giant falling hammer, fought some bad gods. What do you think Mother would say?
That you have come a long way.
Thanks.
What now, then? Maybe Freya ought to have a look at the boy.
No, I feel better now. I just needed to catch my breath. Where do we go next?
Well, now that we've got the giant's chisel, we need to learn the travel rune to Jotunheim, so we can carve it into that special gateway atop the peak and open realm travel to the land of the giants.
You don't know it?
Alas, no. But the Serpent did mention that the giants had entrusted that secret to Tyr.
Isn't Tyr dead?
Aye. But his hidden vault is very much in reach. The doors are beneath his head, submerged in the lake for generations until our snake friend shifted his weight. There we shall find the fabled Black Rune of Jotunheim.
We could also explore some more. We got that chisel now, and that vault isn't going anywhere. Seems a shame to waste the boat.
We shall see, boy.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half god and half giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, he could see what he really wanted in his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. But I can just tell you this story later.
Ooh, Tyr's vault is behind that magical lock.
Setting foot in Tyr's vault.
Another one of these.
It's Tyr, but the middle panel is missing.
Wait, I thought Tyr was a god, not a giant.
Aye, but he was loved by everyone, including the giants. Other than me, he was the only one they gifted with their special sight. Hey, I wonder if the giants left a triptych about me somewhere, too.
Go ahead.
Actually, come look. Let me show you how to read this.
That is not necessary.
You've taught me so much. Let me teach you something.
Atreus.
Come on. You already speak it. Learning to read won't be that hard.
I know how to read, boy. Just not this tongue.
You're halfway there already, then. Okay. So the runes represent a lot of different things. Some gods. Some animals.
Wait.
Oh, am I going too fast? Sorry.
Not that. Do you smell something?
Yeah, I do. Smells like... rain?
You ruined everything! Fucking...
hammer. But now, everyone's gonna think I only got it, cause Magni's gone. It'll be a joke! But if I kill you, no one's gonna laugh at me. Oh, are you dumb? That your father's doing? Or did you get it from your mum? She's stupid and ugly.
Shut up! You don't know anything about my mother.
Oh, it's true. But I'm gonna get to know you really well. You're gonna be my new brother. Right after I finish killing your father! Whoops! I think I broke him! No! Stay back! This isn't over!
Brother, the boy.
Atreus.
You have to get into Freya quickly. There's no other way. Take the boat. Freya's isn't far. Odin's eye is on you, brother, especially now that you've taken to killing his kin. Freya's forest is a blind spot for him. This is our smartest move, and if anyone can heal him, it's her.
What is happening to him?
I've seen it in mortals that some conflict of the mind expresses itself as an ailment of the body. Never in a god. And a god believing himself mortal. I can only imagine. We're almost there. Somebody just called the Serpent.
He is shaking.
It's serious. We must hurry.
Freya! Open the door! We need your help! Woman, do you hear me? It is urgent!
I'm still a god. Go away!
The boy has fallen ill! Freya! He is ill.
Inside. This is no ordinary illness. The boy's true nature, your true nature, fights within him.
I did this to him. Will you help me?
Of course. There is a rare ingredient found only in Helheim. The keeper that protects the Bridge of the Damned. I need its heart.
Hell.
The realm of the dead. Do you know it?
Not this one.
It is a land of unyielding cold. Fires cannot burn there, and no magic in all the nine realms can create a blaze. As for the dead, your frost axe will be useless. You'll need to find something else.
Then I must return home. Dig up a past I swore would stay buried.
Who you were before doesn't matter. This boy is not your past, he is your son. And he needs his father. This rune opens the bridge to Helheim. When you are there, do not, under any circumstances, cross the Bridge of the Damned. There is no road back. Understand?
Boy.
Himele. You must hurry. Through my garden, there's a path leading to my boat. Take it. Return home. Dig up your past. Do whatever you need to do. Just bring me back the Bridgekeeper's heart. And your son may survive.
Last we spoke, I was...
No. You were right to distrust the word of a god. No need to explain. Not to me, not for that. I will keep him safe. That's a mother's promise.
Helheim, of all places. You all right, brother?
I will do what I must. Leave.
There's nowhere you can hide, Spartan. Put as much distance between you and the truth as you want. It changes nothing. Pretend to be everything you are not. Teacher. Husband. Father. But there is one unavoidable truth you will never escape. You cannot change. You will always be a monster.
I know. But I am your monster no longer.
Right, brother, let's see what those blades can do.
Well, in Helheim. Now, I believe I see a door to the realm between realms over there, in your own front yard, no less. Take the shortcut back to the realm travel temple, then on to Helheim, yeah?
Well, I'm pretty sure you weren't talking to me back there. Anything you'd like to get off your chest, brother? I can assure you I'm unsurpassed in keeping confidences. Well, you know where to find me. And for the record, I'd already guessed you were Greek. Athena, dead giveaway.
Foreign magic.
Sweet Nana's nethers. What are those? I've never seen the like.
That's gotta be a family heirloom.
No. Nor will it ever be.
Son, my brother and me created Mjolnir for the big idiot. I know from quality. And them? Them special. Hey, where's the little turd?
He has fallen ill.
No. What happened? Aesir?
No. The fault is mine. And my responsibility to make it right.
Well, we all gotta take responsibility sometime. Huh? Say, what can I do to help him? I can do things. When I should tag along?
No. Your work here is enough.
All right. So where are you off to in such a hurry?
The realm of the dead.
Helheim? Shit, this is serious. I'll be keeping my eye on you.
Now that Freya's given you the travel rune to Helheim, it should be unlocked on the table.
Watching your back.
Let me take this moment to tell you that what you are about to do is absolutely insane. Odin can survive this. So, I hope those blades work.